In this video, we will see a couple of simulations students used as the source of evidence to refine their models of atomic structure. The first simulation is basically a recreation of Thomson's cathode ray tube experiments. Students could vary the metal and see that a green beam is always created, and that green beam always bends towards the positively charged plate. The second simulation works more like a dynamic model, where students can explore some of the relationships between some of the components. Students can choose atoms of different masses and send them between charged plates. From that, students can identify a relationship between the amount of mass a particle has and how much it is affected by the electric field it is sent through. Smaller atoms with less mass will bend more. Students can use the evidence from the first simulation and relationships in this simulation to support the claim that the particles in the cathode ray tube were negatively charged and had much smaller mass than atoms. Students were given time to explore these simulations with their partner and begin answering questions about the simulations. After students did the initial exploration, there was a whole class discussion of the simulation.
In the simulation, what components do we have here? What can we see? Negatives and positives, what?
Different plates. Atoms.
Okay, we have negative and positive plates on the top, negative and positives of different atoms. Other components?
Background.
A background. Anything else? So we have the negative and positive plates and the different atoms. So we said in the cathode ray, were those particles positive or negative? Negative. So if I send a negatively charged atom through here, what do you anticipate will happen?
It will go towards the positive.
It should go towards the positive? Okay. So if I send it, the charge isn't strong enough. So what do I do to make the charge stronger? Okay. So increase the charge on the plate 1,000 times. And now send an atom, and we see it's attracted to the positively charged plate. What if I change it to a different atom?
Same thing.
Same thing will happen?
No.
It's more affected. Okay, so what's different between lithium and hydrogen? Yeah, Rachel.
The mass.
Hydrogen weighs more. What about the mass? Okay. So one relationship we can see is if we change it to a lighter atom, then it goes up a lot more. So is there a relationship there between the amount of mass it has and how much it turns, how much it curves? So what if I send one of the particles from that cathode ray?
It weighs like nothing.
Well, it doesn't have, we're talking about mass. That's two different things. Its mass is like nothing.
Its mass is like nothing? Its mass is like literally nothing, or it's just so small it's like almost basically nothing? It's tiny. We saw there's a relationship between the amount of mass and how much it curves. So less mass makes it curve more. And the particle from the cathode ray, Hina said it's tiny. So what observation is telling us that it's tiny?
It goes up really fast.
How about if I compare it to hydrogen and look at how fast hydrogen goes up compared to the cathode ray particle? Which one goes up faster?
Cathode.
The cathode ray particle. So I'll tell you, hydrogen is the smallest atom in the universe. So what's that tell us about that particle from the cathode ray?
Smaller than an atom.
And what else do we know about that particle from the cathode ray? So negatively charged, smaller than an atom, and its mass is very light. So on the next page, that little particle ended up getting the name electron because it was discovered with experiments using electricity, right? And so what can we say about electrons?
They
You guys just told me three things.
Well, they're inside metals.
No. But from the evidence we just saw, though, what do we know?
They're negatively charged.
We know they're negatively charged. We know. How do we know they're inside of atoms? What did we see? How did their mass compare to an atom's mass?
Lighter.
Lighter than an atom and smaller than an atom, you just told me, right? So those cathode particles eventually got the name of an electron. We know they're negatively charged, smaller than an atom, and have less mass than an atom. So rest of the questions take you through some of Thomson's conclusions and asking you to support with evidence his claims, right? So we've talked about anytime you make a claim, you have to support it with evidence. So you're taking Thomson's claims and providing the evidence for him. And then last couple questions ask you to draw another model of the atom, making sure that your model can explain where those cathode ray particles came from, or where those electrons came from in that beam that went through the cathode ray, right? If you think your old picture of an atom explains that, that's fine. You can include, you can keep that atom. Just make sure you explain how your original picture can account for what Thomson saw. If you need to change your model of the atom to add something new, then you can change it, right? But either way, make sure you're explaining what Thomson saw, how your model accounts for what Thomson saw.
Whenever students are working with their groups or in partners, I continuously circle the room monitoring students' progress. I also respond to students' questions. However, when I respond to students' questions, I always try to point the students to evidence they can use to answer their question as opposed to answering them directly.
So is this your picture of an atom or of the experiment? In the experiment, these plates were made out of atoms, right? So draw like a picture of like one of those atoms that could explain where those little particles came from. Those little negatively charged particles came from, right? So you want a picture of an atom, but your picture of the atom has to be able to explain where those little negative pieces came from.
Okay, so.
Okay,
so how?
Turn this on. This beam is made out of little negatively charged particles. Yeah? Okay, you can switch to the particle view and we can see the little particles. So where are those particles coming from?
The atoms.
Okay. Now if I change that plate, so it's not silver, now it's gold. Where are the particles coming from?
Oh, so like all of the atoms he tested with the cathode ray produced negatively charged electrons.
Yeah, and he tested lots of different metals here. We just included three metals in the simulation.
After students had time to evaluate the simulation and come to some consensus about the evidence that was shown in the simulation, students were then asked to draw models of atomic structure that could account for Thomson's observations. In the next clip, you'll see a whole class discussion of the revised models students made.